Oh, he's going to spend that long on the second move. Shall we just resign this? This freaks me out already, this guy. And there's no track record. When was he on the site? December 16th. 2051, no bullet rating. Okay, I'm freaked out already. Should we go on to another game, yeah? Just move on. Yes, I want to play a player just to get me in the mood for playing this tournament to start off with. Yeah, you know what I mean? That one that doesn't spend so much time on move two. You know, one where there's a rhythm, you can feel a bit of a rhythm. Yeah. Except, oh, it's going to take ages to get a pairing. Oh, that's a problem. Yeah, that's a problem. It's going to take ages to get a pairing. Oh, this was a bad idea, actually. I don't think I've got the patience for this. Thing is, I think it's more believable here that his time thing, because of the rating, low time usage is in relation to the, I believe it. I believe it's more possible, more plausible. Also, I mean, already there's a kind of, this doesn't look right with e6 and g6 with the weaknesses. So I think there's a little bit of hope here. This is going to be a fun game. When I say fun, you know, chance of winning already, because you don't. It's like adding extra weaknesses with G6 and E6. There's more weaknesses. I welcome these weaknesses. Oh boy. This is not the stuff of streaming, is it? This is not really streaming fun, light-hearted content, is it? Because again, unfortunately, the opponent doesn't have too much of a rhythm. But there are weaknesses, so here we go. The rhythm, lack of rhythm, may be compensated by the weaknesses. All right, okay. I might need to castle queenside here, I'm afraid, to mobilize more attacking pieces on the H file. I'm afraid attacking delay seems likely here. Yeah. I did play a bit of 960 on another site. I kind of enjoyed it sometimes. I know that I became aware you can lose very quickly from certain start positions if you're not careful. You've got to be very careful not to lose in two moves in chess 960. Now, yeah, you might be wondering about this e6 pawn, and you're right. The e6 pawn does seem to be hanging. I could have just taken that. I can take it here as well, maybe with greater effect. If I can knock out this bishop, then this one for f5, and then knock out the bishop with or win the queen for 6 million pieces. Takes, knight takes. Maybe two pieces is a good deal for the queen. Two minor pieces. Now I'm looking forward to h6 again. If I knock out g7, then there's f5. Knight moves, bishop e5. Well, it's all pretty disastrous, I think, for black now. Pretty disastrous. Maybe, in fact, yeah. I might want to actually delay things a bit, I'm afraid, to hold the center more. What is it, rook e4? All right, so f5, knight f5. F5. Knight F5. I think I need. I'm afraid I think I still need to castle. Can I just do this without castling? Rook takes H6. Check. Here. Doesn't do anything. Oh, it's Bishop H6. Here. Okay. I think I need to castle again. Is this boring? Yeah. Tell me, if one is super boring and 10 is exciting, be honest. Vote it, yeah. Be honest, because I don't think this is Twitch material, because people expect arcade games or something on Twitch, yeah. When we're not going to miss the hyperbullet. The hyperbullet's at 9. Don't tell me the hyperbullet's now. Is the hyperbullet at 9? Yeah. It's sometimes it is exciting if there's the rhythm, you know. It's all about the rhythm. Hang on, I think I'm missing a documentary on Amy Winehouse. When's that documentary on Amy Winehouse? Is that now? Seriously, can someone be honest? Will it be on Catch Up TV? Amy Winehouse story. Oh boy. Oh, this is like playing in a 3 day tournament or something against someone 1800 from Japan, where you could spend 3 hours traveling there, 8 hours to lose. 3 hours traveling back and lose 20 FIDE rating points. That's fun, isn't it? Yeah. Not that I've, that's not that that's ever happened to me. Never. Oh boy. Oh man. Oh God. Is this game over? Is it over yet? Is it over yet? Is it over yet? Please let it be over. Please let it be over. Ah, this game is going on too long. Okay, what's the quickest way? I don't know. What's the quickest way to win this? Going with the queen. Is there some sort of medal for winning one of these games or something? I think medals need to be awarded for each win. Yeah? Sticking it out medal. Yeah? We're on the scoreboard here. 3 points. I need some quick moving bunnies. I need some quick moving bunnies, please. Are there not any bunnies that move quickly in this tournament? Please, there must be one or two. Bunnies that do not use the full clock allowance. Nope. Apparently not. All of these bunnies must be accountants during the day or something. They must do something extremely boring. These are the most boring bunnies on the site. Yeah. These are the most boring bunnies on the site I'm playing here. They're accountants or something. Yeah. I'm going to kick the knight. Okay, let's imagine bishop g5. There's c3, there's a check. That would be exciting. No, there's no check. Because the knight's covered. I'll just notice the knight's covered. Will he notice that? That there's no check. Nope, it doesn't. Okay. I anticipated a blunder here. Isn't that amazing? I anticipated a blunder on the classical time control. That's quite a feat, isn't it? Ooh. We're in pole position after that. No, actually, someone said counting was exciting to me once, and I believed them. I was working for ICL in the workplace, but they said not the ordinary bog standard accountants, but there's these more dynamic thinking accountants that I think corporate strategy accountants. I think there's something about knowing how a business is modeled through the accountancy model, so you get to understand how more about businesses. Yes, it sounded really convincing at the time. It could sort of way of modeling the business. It was very exciting. Okay, so exciting. And this is a 5 minute game anyway. We're having a 5 minute game here. Isn't this fun? I know I played some ridiculous gambit as usual. And it's weakening his diagonal. And weakening it a bit further. Does it matter? Queen here, knight here. Bishop b6. It's weakening a bit h2 now, potentially. H2. Oh, it's definitely weakened the dark squares. There's nothing more incisive. Well, I can take here first. I mean, that's more what they say. Incisive is the word to do this. But then there's knight f3, I don't know, rook f3, g takes, queen h4. Okay, rook f2, knight takes. There's no check, I think I'll just take queen e3, queen f. Check. The check here could threaten to win that knight. No, I think if you have a choice between, if you had to get wanted money on a steady basis, I mean, the choice between a GM or whatever, or not even an IM, and becoming an accountant, I think it's better to be an accountant. Yeah, who votes accountant? Yeah, over chess professional anytime. If you had that choice and you wanted to feed a family, seriously, what would you choose? I mean, one's pretty stable, one's, I think you have to be mad. I don't know, unless you're really good and going to win every single tournament. Yeah, what do you think? If you had a choice between being an accountant or a chess professional, and you can get to at least IM strength, but you're not guaranteed to be a GM, what would you choose? So IM or accountant. So you get qualified to be a basic accountant, or you could be an IM. What would you choose? Vote now. You choose IM and not start a family? No. How comes I've never played any of these people? Isn't that strange? I've never played any of these people. Have they never played on Bullet? None of these bunnies have played any Bullet chess on the site. I've never played them, ever played them on the site. Never, ever played them on the site. Isn't that a bit odd? I am in school teacher. Oh man, I am in school teacher. Really? I think someone said a paradox. I am single officer. I think you need money to attract women later on in life, and especially it helps. So I don't know. It's a bit of a paradox just being mentioned there. I think if you're a rich accountant, you might have more chance. F4 could be good. There's an F4, and there's a G file here. There's a nice Moroxy bind in reverse. But, you know, I like this G file. That's not bothering me that much at the moment. The e4 square, knight h4, bishop f5. Maybe it should. Bishop f5. This sort of, it's dangerous. Actually, immediately for f3 springs to the mind as being an immediate and clear present danger. F3 is threatened. could have played F3, couldn't he? just to get the queen onto the g file, or just move this bishop so I can play rook g8. That's queen e3 on this one. Rook g8. Oh, hang on. Queen e3 is knight f5. Gaining a tempo. That leaves rook g8 on the cards, and in fact, there's now h5 on the cards to knight g4. Let's see, knight g4, there's h5. Oh, no, he doesn't want to do that. Don't want to do that. That's a bad mistake, as far as I can see. It's a bad one. Is running into this guy with a check on the g-file. I said the g-file was dangerous. How come we accumulate more viewers to this classical stream than in the previous bullet? Do these streams accrue viewers or something when they're slower time control? Or is it because of all the debate about accountants that's attracted a bigger audience? Okay, so yeah, we've got double the point. I didn't expect this. We've actually got double the points here than the number two. This is good from a tournament point of view. The opening gambit of the quick resign has paid off. Yeah. Actually, I know the story of a chess IM who was an accountant, a real life story, case study, Peter Large, and he used to be winning all the George Goodwin rapid plays, even if there were GMs. He'd still win these George Goodwin rapid play tournaments, these one day 30 minutes. And yes, I spoke to him about it, and me and Demis Sapis actually kind of interviewed him once, and he said, when he stopped becoming an accountant and tried to be a chess professional, his chess wasn't so good. So I think he needed some stability financially to be able to actually focus on his chess more. Yeah, that's an example I know of, actually, of an IM accountant, Peter Lodge. Does that ring a bell with anyone? You're probably all too young, aren't you, to know the name Peter Lodge? Anyone know the name Peter Lodge? Peter Lodge? I am Peter Lodge. Anyone know the name? You're all too young, probably, yeah? Are you? Anyone know the name? He used to win these rapid play tournaments on the weekend. I got close to mating him once, but no, I got close to winning on time, but he mated me with like less than 1 second on his clock. Runaway Sked, you know him. Yeah, he was really good on the rapid play chess. It was my ambition to get on the stage and one day to beat him, but I don't think it ever happened. I don't think I ever beat him, ever. So, rook g3. Yeah, he was the terror of the rapid play tournaments, a real terror. He could beat GMs on it. Okay, this seems like there's no real attack here. This is a bit of a concern, this position, you know. Not just the immediate back row concern or black able to double rooks. It's just that there's no, I can't see any major. Maybe I should play a3. This back row is going to get a bit naughty. a3 might be better than b3 because the queen could come in here. I wonder if he doubles just a3. But I don't have. Oh, actually, a3 is is almost a good move in its own right for bishop b4. If it wasn't for c5. It doesn't do anything. I'll do it anyway. If I get this position, there's rook g7. That's interesting. Rook g7. Queen h7. Let's have a go at this. But I'm not actually fretting anything here. So he just ignores it, as one does. Let's threaten mates. Now if rook g8, there's rook h6. Queen g8. Interesting. I didn't think he'd allow this sort of crude caveman attack, you know? Because this is the classical time control. I think I could safely pre-move this, so in case I lose connection, I'm going to safely pre-move queen takes g8. Ron Mayscare, do I know you from ECF circles? I won the Lloyds Bank Junior 1989, yes. That was around the time Peter Large was playing, yeah. Do I know you? What ECF? Who are you? Ron Mayscare, do I know you from ECF circle tournaments? I've managed to get 8 Pepsi Max cherries, you know, from the co-op. I've got 8 of them. Did you know this sugar tax potential? They might even tax these drinks which are not supposed to have sugar, which I find a bit weird, because I thought the whole point of having them is that they didn't have sugar, right? So not only are these dark cloud proposals of a sugar tax, yeah, but they're even gonna think about, I don't know, these horrible ideas going around that they're gonna tax sugar, and then even drinks which don't even have sugar in them, yeah? Is that like an aspartame tax on top of it or something? Can't you get away, can't you have your like diet drinks, you know, without having to pay tax or something, you know? If you want to kill yourself, you know, it's up to you, isn't it? Slowly, yeah? Oh, man. Okay, it's a theoretical position. Oh, dear. I've just realized, guys, this is against a 2259. This is a theoretical position. I should be worried, shouldn't I? Should we just resign this? Should we just try and crush the bunnies instead? Oh, this could be a slow, painful death, this game. That's what I'm trying to say. This game could be a slow, painful death, right? Should we just resign, yeah? Should we just resign? This is a theoretical position, for God's sake. D4's well-known theory. Yeah, you don't have to analyze this position. I think it's D4 anyway. This might be another move. I don't know. It looks like it's a nice center to attack with. Why didn't I berserk it? I've just realized I didn't even berserk this game. I didn't even berserk this game. Okay, doesn't matter. Doesn't matter now. Profile, dossier, bullet 2302, 2306 on bullet. We have a significant clock advantage. I'm just gonna pull some teeth. I'm just gonna go downstairs and get a teeth puller, right? Come back and pull teeth on stream, yeah? So I put a webcam to it as well, yeah? Okay, well, while we're waiting for the move, yeah? Actually, I don't have any teeth to pull out. Sorry, that's not funny. Forget I said that. I might have my annual checkup. Actually, text messaged me from the dentist though. Oh no, I've just plundered the queen. Sorry, I didn't mean to do that. I was trying to do an arrow. Sorry. No, seriously, that was an accident. I didn't mean to throw away the game in one move. Sorry. I didn't mean to play that. I'm being honest. I'm being 100% honest. I didn't mean to play knight e1. I was enjoying the position for a moment. I didn't mean to play knight e1. I'm being honest. It's not because I wanted to lose the game instantly. No, seriously. Seriously, it was a kind of... I was trying to do an arrow, yeah, with Queen E1. That was the intention. I wanted to do an arrow with Queen E1. I'm sorry. Sorry about that. On the other hand, there's a nicer rhythm to this game, isn't there? I honestly was going to try and do an arrow, yeah? Honestly, I was trying to do an arrow for you guys, yeah? Queen E1. It was taking an age, though. There's always a silver lining, yeah. It was taking an age, that game, anyway. Yeah, you know it was taking an age. But even though it was taking an age, you know, I was intrigued myself, yeah, about the possibilities. And I didn't do it intentionally. No, seriously, I did not do it intentionally. Who thinks I did it intentionally? Yeah. Did I do it intentionally? Yes or no? Seriously, do you think I did that intentionally to throw away the game? I was trying to do an arrow for Queen E1. Yeah? Honest. This game's got a nicer rhythm to it, though, I got to say. And that's being honest as well. I think this game's got a nicer rhythm to it. And there's an F2 juicy target here, yeah? There's also a potential loose piece on C4, potential loose piece on G5, and a potential mate on H2. So I think tactically it looks very nice, this position. And I've even remembered to berserk it, yeah? is there a back row issue? Let's just check the back row issues. Queen d2, bishop f2, rook f2. Rook f2. There's queen d8. Unfortunately, he can survive another day. Can he? Is there anything more incisive than this to allow queen... Oh, no. Is he surviving another day? What about Rook F2? Maybe that's more incisive. Because here, then there's check, winning the queen. If takes, then there's check. The back row is still a concern. Oh, let's just do this. If he wants the queens off, he wants the queens off, right? Or queen d8. What can I do? Nope. Okay. Now either take the bishop or here, but this is a back row mate. That would be embarrassing. Even more embarrassing than the previous episode. Okay. Connect these rooks sometime to avoid this kind of tactical humiliation. Bishop, move somewhere. Knight e3, bishop g, not bishop g3. Okay, I think I'll go here. No, I won't. Queen here takes, queen takes, queen here. I've got to be careful with the arrows on this time control. It's a shame to waste many minutes of a game doing arrows, which actually accidentally move. Got to be careful with the arrows. The danger of arrows. Arrows. Slings and arrows of outrageous fortune. Bishop takes g4. Bishop f3. Rook takes f2, not here, because there's queen d8. Right, queen h4. And queen takes f4. Rook takes f2, queen takes f2, queen takes f4, rook takes f4. Why isn't queen takes f4? Queen h2, bishop h2. That's still pinned. I think queen takes f4 overall. Looks as though it's not a major tactical disaster. I might be wrong. As always, bishop takes g3. On g3, even. If I needed to play g4, which I don't. There's always g5 if there's a rook coming to here. g5. Giving the king here. I mean, it's over. It's over, surely. I've got the advantage of the bishop pair, i.e., two extra bishops. And bishop pair advantage always is a good advantage to have in chess. The advantage of the bishop pair, especially if the opponent is two bishops down. Now, unless I blunder my rook, in which case I think white could win. If I blundered my rook, I'd probably still be winning, but it would complicate things. So the check. And the bishop pair. Okay, here we go. How to mate with rook and two bishops? How tricky. Maybe bishop g3 first, so it stops, and then this one, and then the rook over here. So we got this, all the squares covered. Now, if the rook goes back to base, actually can be taken. If the rook plays check here, it can be taken. Right. Unfortunately, there's a killer 1768 in the tournament who's berserking as well. Otherwise, this would be a would have been a runaway tournament. Unfortunately, it's not the case. He's about the same opponent ratings as him. Oh God, should we just profile 1394 on bullet. Now this is one of those magical players that has a 1394 rating on bullet chess and yet has faultless play given a few extra minutes. Yeah, isn't it? It's going to be one of those players, is it? He's in fourth position in the tournament. Sorry, I shouldn't say like that. But look, you know, most top players do not play this time control. You know, this is, you know, you have to, you know, think of this stream as self-sacrifice and humiliation. Yeah, this time control. Yeah. Ah. All right, he's letting me build up. I think his play is a little bit dodgy, his play. I think it's there's some weaknesses here, but hang on, I've just realized he's 2182, right, and he's 1397 in bullets. Hang on, does that strike anyone as a bit odd? Is he on BT internet or something, a bad version? And he can't play bullet. Look, 2182. Hang on. Yes, am I getting this right? He's 2182 on this time control. I don't mean to cause alarm, but 2182 and 1397. Maybe he's got bad internet. Okay, I'm gonna imagine this is a good position. Superficially, it's the sort of position I'd normally welcome. Because it seems completely winning. But there might be hidden resources here, I don't know. It doesn't look as though there are. Actually, after that, I'm not so sure now. He has actually destroyed my bishop. So I wouldn't put any bets on this. Because that bishop has been locked out. I'm probably worse here, yes. I've probably got a lost position, in fact. Nevertheless. Can I? Because I'm wondering, you know, there's knight of six. Oh, there's always. And take it. With this bishop locked out of the game, I'm not very hopeful now about the position. Somehow, I think all of his plays made sense, unfortunately. And he's going to win that bishop. But unless there's some strange attack, which he might underestimate, I think it's defensive capabilities have been shown here. Can I get this bishop on this diagonal? Rook is counter attack as well, time, isn't that? G5. I can get this bishop out at least. G5. Actually, E5 would have been would have been interesting. Maybe. Running into rook h7 now. g6, knight takes. No, not knight takes. It's starting to look a bit lost. For me. I mean, I don't know. Unless knight takes e5. Unless. Is there still some hope here? Oh no, I've just blundered the bishop. Oh no, I think that's a bad blunder. I've blundered the bishop. I wouldn't say. He didn't take the bishop even. This is one mysterious game. But again, I'm not in any position to am I? Attack anything. Unless there's, I don't know. This bishop's dead. In fact, I don't know. Oh, all right, I can open up the bishop at least now. Protecting the pawn, so there's actually potential for a checkmate with King g3, Rook h2, Knight f6 at the moment, which I'm sure he'll spot, right? Yeah. I can still throw this check in. Looks pretty dangerous. I'll play this as a. Right. No. Bishop d5. No, I'm going to lose this pawn on bishop d5 at some point. Knight. I think it's a goner. This looks like slow death time. Here's material up. He's actually okay, he's two pawns up. The attack looks a bit unsound. Not sure though. I can't really see any prospect here. No, I can't see any prospect here. One little cheapo or not? I don't even know if that's a cheapo. It's not really. Actually, is the knight takes e5? Nope. He's always got b3 now, so that's winning. Knight g6, king h. I could try and do. Nope. I don't think so. Nope. I think this is gone now. Like, I'll safely resign that. I found the game extremely weird, actually. He didn't take a bishop at several points. Maybe he was playing stronger moves. I don't know. I don't know. It's juicy. Juiciness is approaching. You can feel the rhythm of this game is a bit quicker, can't you? Knight d5, queen g5. I think I can get to play queen f6 soon. Oh, actually, queen g5. Actually, this diagonal might even be an idea. There's no check, that's covered. Here. Maybe check and D3. Or just D3. We'll just take here. Oh no, it's plundered the rook now. Oh god. Things are getting a bit bad now. Plundered the rook. Oh, have I got any advantage now? Oh, I thought I was winning this easily. Now I'm not so sure. Oh, hang on, hang on. I think I'm at least getting the bishop. This is a crazy game. This is even crazier than the one before, but in a nice way. Not a slow death, painful way. More of a quick win. Okay. So who was that one? Just lost them there. There's already evident weaknesses, yeah? You realise that. Unless White really knows what he's doing with the bobolink system, there's evident weaknesses. White's got to kind of usually play like that in the bobolink system. I guess you can play it like that, though. Oh, yeah. I'll go for a quick hag. The rook saying hello, hello, something's up here on the h file. Rook's all, my rook is getting all excited. But there's bishop g5. Unfortunately, that could be a good move. Or this, maybe. F6. Oh, there's bishop h5 as well. Well, there's actually, you know, queen f6, queen over here, and other crude things. Actually, queen f6 we see a focal point there. So even knight d5 actually loses bishop f2 immediately. Oh, this one doesn't look good. I just take and take. Let's imagine knight f3 for sake of argument. It keeps the queen out of h4. Okay, it's not. Queen e3 is an immediate threat. Rook f3. Check. 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 Isn't that mate there? Because the king hasn't got f2. The king hasn't got e2. So I think rook f3, check, 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 it's mate on h1. Yeah, he's resigned, actually, he's resigned. But there's someone with a spooky nickname. Don't tell me he's just joined the site today. Please don't tell me. Has this guy just joined the site today? November. Okay. Okay. You see, I've got no track record against most of these players. Look, again, no track record. Isn't that weird? Does anyone find that a bit weird? This is like a different segment of the site. That never played bullet chess or rapid. Super Blitz. Oh, hang on, hang on. There's the daily hyper bullet. What are we going to do with the daily hyper bullet? Are we going to sacrifice the daily hyper bullet? Okay, hyper bullet or Pascal. Vote now. It's the hyper bullet time. No? I'm not sure I can play both. I don't think, can you technically, I don't think you can technically play in two tournaments at the same time. But if one of them is hyper bullet, I don't think you can really do anything else but hyper bullet. Yeah. Okay, what is this? I don't know, let's try and... I hate to be boring, but should we just try and do what we did in the previous game? To be honest, I don't know. It's good that we're leading the tournament. If we weren't leading the tournament, if we were like nowhere, I'd say hyper bullet time, but given we're in pole position at the moment, there's no. How many pawns? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 3, 4, 5, 6. Actually, rook f7 might have been. I just realised rook f7 might have been good. Oh well. So he's protected both those pawns, so he's nullified from g4 for a moment. The check, king here. There's nothing really. This knight is wanting to do something, maybe over here, or I don't know about over here. Bishop's kind of defensive. I think e6 is a nice target. I'm going to go with this. Is he parrying that somehow? Bishop here? No? No? Oh well. Another question then, what does knight actually do there? Okay, it's actually doing something now. Check, win the queen. There's queens there. Check, we'll win the queen. If he goes back, actually this is mating. Right, that's a different question though. Just do nothing for a moment. What does he do? Is he aiming my pawns? Like pawns. Keeps on over there. That's a problem. If I just try and nudge the king away, he'll just go back, right? Right, there's also f4 tanks. I'm not sure what that is. And there's a pawn. That knight looks as though it is trapped. With king f7 coming up, the knight's actually a tactical liability. That's funny, isn't it? Yeah, this is not so hot, this position. It's a bad position though. If he ever took queen h6, if I wasn't getting mated, that would be quite good though. Maybe I'm gonna try that. But unfortunately, I think this is just winning a piece actually. King f7 looks to be winning a piece. That knight, poor knight, is stranded after king f7. Is it the end of the world? I'd say probably, but there's a few pawns here. How many pawns? There's two pawns for the bishop. Maybe there's perpetual. There's a check here. King e2. Two pawns for the bishop doesn't bode well. Queen. No, this does not bode well. Okay. There must be some useful checks. Next, there's also this attacking bit here potentially. Takes check, queen. There's queen d5, keeps an eye on. I keep an eye on d3 at least. A4, a5 here. I assume he's playing for a win, being a bishop up. He would actually stop a few checks. Try and keep the queens on. There is a question, technically, I shouldn't be playing this on because I've actually only got a pawn for the bishop. Not sure. Oh, but he's let me now fix. I don't know. He's going to come in with queen b4. No. Unless I'm holding a4. Okay, 46 seconds to 3 minutes. Can I get at least get a perpetual check? That's an interesting question. Some sort of perpetual check. He's closing in with that bishop, isn't he? Mind you, if I got rid of the queens here, I think he'd still be winning. If I got rid of this pawn, then I'd still be winning, wouldn't he? He's got the right bishop for this pawn as well. seconds remain. Thank you. Oh, that's unfortunate. He's got Queen C5. Huh? He resigned? Oh no, Queen C5 is winning for him. Queen C5, he just wins. Surely. Maybe he thought it was being mated or something. I'm sorry, I don't mean to laugh. I was expecting Queen C5, yeah? Queen C5! Queen C5! Oh, gold. This is the nickname that frightens me, that says I'm an engine abuser from Yahoo Chess. Remember Yahoo Chess? This nickname says to me, remember Yahoo Chess? I'm one of those morons that used to be on Yahoo Chess. Oh. Do you guys really want me to play this game? Seriously. I think this is going to end up badly. Yeah, you can tell from nicknames and maturity levels, can't you? Yeah? You don't have to be Sherlock Holmes, yeah? Or is that pure discrimination? Can you not tell from nicknames the level of maturity of someone? Mind you, his position though at the moment, I would say, you know, I like the position in certain respects. Actually, he did berserk, you know. Oh no, I think this is going to be good for black. He's undoubled his pawns. It's kind of a loose piece liability he's probably going to exploit. I don't mean to be negative about it, but... Alright, let's carry on though. Let's carry on. It looks okay for the moment. F5 or E5. Maybe E5 then F5. F6. Maybe over here. There's a tactical refutation of that or not? C4, rook takes two. I'll go for this anyway, because I'm thinking rook e7 here if I lose this. So he takes, rook e7. And he's gone for this rook. Well, there's time for queen g4 or queen g5. Queen g5 stops queen d2. It's got the added bonus. This check is killer, isn't it? Let's just go back. Okay, I think f6 is something somewhere. Hey, here, yeah, hang on. Oh, being let off. Had some luck, haven't I, in this talk? Well, definitely. Seven rows, surely on my preview here it shows the whole thing with thing underneath the board. You might be shocked that I've just castled here. I mean, I'm sorry, I haven't used Harry the H pawn in this game. I apologize. Harry was busy. he was on holiday, yeah? Okay, knight takes e5. Is that losing instantly or not? I can't see it. I can't see it. It's defended to me. It's defended visually to me, as the human eye and basic calculation indicates that h7 at the moment is adequately defended. Is it not? Sorry, have I got this wrong? I'm going to take this guy off to avoid getting mated. Two pieces up, thanks. That's very generous. Bishop f4, knight f. Get rid of this one as well. Oh, that's all nice. It's all very generous. I've got the classic advantage of the bishop pair again. The bishop pair strikes again. Yeah. I got the firing squad ready, yeah. The firing squad is ready for the king, yeah. Oh, there's a message on the chat by Folyman. I'm reading out by Folyman, yeah. Be sure to check out Daydreamers Games. It's probably Coulson in the Skies. 40 move game with 6 average centre pawn loss. But didn't we beat Daydreamer earlier? No, we lost to Daydreamer. Oh, guys. Sorry. Calling Team King's Crusher. Team King's Crusher. Can you check out Daydreamer? Engine alert. Hang on, we lost the Daydreamer. Was Daydreamer an engine? Check his games. Daydreamer 29. The thing is, it's sort of academic actually, because he's only on 24 points. He's not really heading to win the tournament, is he? Should we just say forget it? Doesn't matter. Unless I had to play him multiple times, it wouldn't be good fun. I mean, otherwise, I mean, it's does it matter? Yeah, that's the thing. Does it matter? I know he's not in contention of winning the tournament, though. Oh, sorry, someone's already set Morpheus out. Sorry, yeah, okay, that wasn't. Yeah, okay, what can you do? What can you do, yeah? Does anyone, okay, if you want, I mean, report it. I mean, if you think it's something worth reporting, I mean, there is a possibility I'll be paired against them again. I mean, that might spoil something. Unless, on the other hand, you might like me playing engines and being completely massacred. Yeah? Because I know people often ask for me to play on the ICC 5-minute auto pairing. Yeah, same sort of thing. It used to be fun. There was a time, you know, 2-3 years ago, it was fun, yeah, to play on the ICC 5-minute auto pairing. Then there was a time about a year ago I preferred playing IMs and GMs to playing untitled players with ratings over 2300 but no blitz ability. I actually preferred There was a time about a year ago I preferred to play IMs and GMs, yeah, but recently I just couldn't be bothered. That's why I've gone to the 3-minute as a safer haven, you know. But the games are pretty bad. They're often decided by a tactical blunder. That there isn't much depth to them. There's a downside to everything basically that you do. I mean, there's a downside, yeah. I mean, some of these games, there's more scope for, you know, obviously talking about the positions. This position's okay, isn't it? If knight f4, you know, takes, you know, f3, I can't see that at the moment is too terrible a position with the knight on e4. I don't see how that's completely terrible. Because I've blocked in the bishop, right? Or rather, he's blocked in the bishop. It's okay, the knight's a bit sickly, but he can always come out later. You can use the c file. I mean, the position looks okay to me. Actually, this threatens knight takes d6. Okay, I'll get the pawns off. Hang on. Is the position okay? Try and reinforce e4. I think I played a casual move there. I should have played knight f1 the move before. because now he can just take that off. I would have liked to have kept a knight on. Maybe it doesn't matter. I'm just wondering, does it matter? And get a knight back. There's always rook e3 then. This supports rook e3s. So it would have been nice to have. Okay. Now there's a pin here. I know the opponent's got the bishop pair, but you've got to factor in the knight on e4 here. And it's. Actually, there's also this pawn I've just. Actually. No, he can't take that pawn. Rook takes c8, queen takes, knight takes d6. He can't take that pawn. But he could actually take it like this. Takes, bishop takes. He hasn't done so. To protect the pawn. Weaknesses. Okay. All right. I'll do that. It's probably. It's as good as any other, probably. I don't know. Save the A pawn. Save the A pawn. Sometimes you've just got to save the A pawn, haven't you? It's not as if I'm busy with something exciting on the other side of the board anyway, at the moment. I just need to get the knights reinforced, get the H file, which he's just given me. I'm going to be happy with a knight on e4, I tell you. I'm going to be happy with this knight on e4. It's an octopus knight, I tell you. Octopus. Look at this knight. Look at all the squares. Yeah. Look, I wouldn't have time to show you in a bullet game. Look at all the squares the knight is covering. Isn't that amazing? Queen here, queen here. Queen here, bouncing off some angles here. Queen d1 to b3. Can save the pawn. This check. Coming to think about it, it's a loose piece. I'm threatening actually check as well. I can play this, and then. Queen b3 check. Didn't factor that one in, did he? Did he miss that one? This is looking like a loose piece. Spoiler. That spoilt the evil plan. Dear, oh dear. There's a more subtle idea of rook e5, queen b3. I'm going to try that more subtle as a brick plan. Queen b3 there. Rook e5. Right, I like this. C4 for the nine knights, as happy as parrots. By the way, my parrot still is not whistling. I don't know, it's been a few days. I'm a bit worried still. Polly has stopped whistling, but is talking and eating on the bright side. I don't know if there's any parrot gurus. It's a yellow Amazon. I kept saying it was a green Amazon. It's actually a yellow Amazon. You should be able to say that from the color of the neck, right? But yeah, I don't know. I don't know if it's some sort of cold. No idea, really. The problem is it's over 60 years old, probably, the parrot, and it's in a massive cage. Can't exactly take this parrot to a vet, yeah? And if you get a vet to come, you know, it's ridiculous, yeah? They'll charge £100, and all they'll bring with them, you know, is the death sentence. They won't bring any of their stuff. I think, you know, I think from what I've read, it's either... Okay, hang on a sec. Hang on. Knight E5, Knight G5. How do the knights work here? Do they actually do anything? That's interesting. Let's do a move and see what black does for a moment. Actually, black's in time trouble. I've just realized black is actually in time trouble here. Right, knight g5, threaten mate. And now there's also a loose rock here, right? Which means it's bad news. That means it's bad news. So we're 12 points ahead. Berserk lost 3, 4, 5, 6 games successfully, which is usually a good thing. The berserk rate is 100%, isn't it? Didn't I berserk nearly every game? No, probably approaching 100%. What's the performance rating? It's not yet showing. Oh, did that one depart from the tournament again? Oh god, is this another that joined today? Please tell me joined January. Oh, okay, I love playing people that just joined the other day. I really do. That have question marks, I love it. Ah. Oh, man. Okay, here we go. I think, you know, the most important tournaments on the site, you should let anyone that's just joined on that day into them, yeah? Oh god, should we just resign? Okay, I'm gonna do a vote here. Resign now, yeah? Should we just resign now? It's a question mark. It's a question mark player. Look, I'll give you a profile. Bullet, 1496. Yeah, joined January 3rd. Okay, that's 5 days ago. That is 5 days ago, to be fair. Okay, 5 days ago. That looks a bit of a suspect, weird move, h4. I mean, weird as in bad move, you know, not weird as in, you know, super fantastic move. Yeah. I'm threatening now d4. I mean, this is obviously out of place. It's created unnecessary weaknesses, you know. Obviously, I mean, it's created unnecessary weaknesses, it seems. If he sacks, I think I just play knight here. I don't think I'm sort of if I take toes. End up playing f takes g5. What's this? Okay, what is this? No. It's good I didn't resign then. It's good. I mean, it's good so far. Didn't resign. I'm happy with the decision not to resign this game from earlier. Well done, those that voted not to resign. Just because you're playing a question mark, yes, could be just an innocent person that joined the site five days ago that likes the stream or whatever. Okay. But threatening to win a piece. Can I keep the thing, the position, or the thing? When I say the thing, I don't mean the thing as in, is it John Carpenter's horror film, The Thing? No, I mean, can I keep the h6 bishop, brother? I didn't want to have this position, right? Because that's a little bit passive, because then there's no f6, is there ever? The knight's a bit squished. Hang on a sec. Okay, I think I can manage it from Queen F5, takes check. It's a sort of a rook up, basically, isn't it? Actually, there's also Queen here. Oh, there's news on the thing, Rick G. But I meant to offer a draw because I saw you had perpetual check. But press resigned by accident. That was from Rick G on the tournament chat. That really helped have a win streak. That blunder, huh? So it's true that quotation from Tartakovo, was it? No, was it from Tartakovo? No game was ever lost by resigning. Yeah? It's apparently true. I mean, who would have thought? Well, is it true? Is it true? No game was ever won by resigning. What if, there was a bigger game at stake, yeah? And by resigning, you would win over, the princess. Yeah, exactly. It doesn't make sense, does it? How can you say that categorically, that no game was ever won by resigning? You can't really say that, can you? It really depends. Yeah. Maybe, resigning could be the best thing, yeah. The bigger game, the bigger game could be at stake. Bishop takes h6. I don't know, that just loses a piece here, doesn't it? There's just knight h7. It's rubbish, isn't it? So h3. I don't know, how to get this attack going? Hell. There's no attack here, is there? There's only 16 minutes of the tournament left. This game could last 12 minutes potentially. Well, I doubt it. I'm not sure I'm going to use all my 5 minutes. But I don't think this sort of thing really does any favours, does it? Unless this knight can go over here. Yeah. In the meantime, bishop f6 to g7 happens. The queen is evicted. I don't think that attack will work. Black will then play like this and have the G file and be a piece up. On the other hand, it looks like a little bit of fun, so let's do it anyway. Yeah, that might not happen. I mean, it's just a bad scenario that that might happen, it might not happen. The knight who does want to be here, right? On g3. This one. Oh, he's letting me get the knight on g3. So I get both knights like this. Knight h7 to stop knight g5. Knight g3 so that knight h5. Bishop f6. Actually, this is in time anyway. So now there's no bishop f8 because of this. There's no knight h7 because of this. And knight g3 to h5 is happening. Maybe rook f3 to g3 or h3. This is a very different scenario from the one painted earlier because there's two very strong attacking knights. There's a pawn wedge attacking pawn wedge. Right, I can take here. It's not even material down. Unless the queen's getting trapped. Oh, hang on. Is the queen getting trapped? Yeah, the queen's getting trapped. Oh, wish I didn't say that. Unfortunately, the queen's getting trapped. Bishop g7. That's the downside of this. Queen's getting trapped. Whoa, didn't see that. There's knight e6 takes. That doesn't help. Not so rosy now, is it? Queen f7. Queen is trapped. I didn't see that at all. Yeah, maybe more calculation was needed, huh? Queen is trapped. Unless there's something brilliant that I'm missing. I'll take her. Let's get a pawn. So much for the amazing attack. I thought it was going to be an amazing attack there. It's all gone. The dream has ended. So how many pawns are we talking about? 4, 5, 6. All the pawns are there. So it's 3 pawns for a piece. So that's okay. F6 takes. There's knight h5. Rook e6. Here there's rook g6. Maybe just threaten f6 with the idea rook f1 knight h5 bishop f6. The bishop's still shut out, so I wouldn't say this is too bad. Still didn't need to do that. Oh, didn't even need to do that. Shouldn't have done that. Didn't need to do it. Sorry, didn't need to do it. It's done anyway. Okay, it's just a weak pawn now. It was shutting out the bishop quite happily. It's a weak, I've just created a weak pawn unnecessarily. Bishop can probably come to a dangerous diagonal. Mind you, rook a5 could be an argument. Rook e8. Oh, okay, h3 for a starter. Stop bishop g4, king here, rook here. Knight here, g4. Sorry, like king g3, h4, g5. Just keep the bishop in prison. Hang on. This one? There's rook e8. Here. To keep the bishop in prison. It's a common theme here, isn't it? Keep this bishop locked away. Let's advance these pawns. Keep the bishop in prison. G4, and this is a sack. Bring the king up. So b4, c3, takes, there's d4 there. h5, b4 to stop these guys. c3 takes, undoubles the pawns, and there's d4. It takes e5, keeps the bishop in prison as well. I think b4 is a prelude, because otherwise there's c5. b4 is a prelude to c3. No sack just yet. So I'll play this to stop these two. And c3 to hit this pawn chain hard. I might have to upload this commentary because it's better than a lot of the 3-minute rubbish I've been uploading to YouTube recently. Yeah. Oh no, it tactically fails. Rook takes g4. That I didn't see that at all, funny enough. I didn't see that at all. No, that I wasn't looking out for that. It's a shame. Ah, that ruins the whole position really, doesn't it? Does it? Okay, I think I have to does it? Hang on, yes it does. Yes, it does. This knight's pinned. Couldn't you have left me in peace? I was doing nicely there. Knight g7. Oh, that's wrecked. It's just, let's face it, it's wrecked. Oh, he's gonna treble. It's wrecked. The position is gone. It's gone. Rook h4. Rook h4, knight f5. Nope. This looks like bad news. Bad news. So knight d6 to win this one. Takes. Then there's a check. Then there's taking here. We can take here. It's going to end up a piece up, at least. I'll go for this scenario analogous to previous game, where I've got one or two pawns for a piece. It's not really happening. Is it? No, this looks really bleak. Because I'm just losing all the pawns. It's kind of resignable. I'm gonna resign it. I don't wanna try that one out particularly. I think the rook takes g4 are just crushing, bone crushing, king's crushing. Rook takes g4. I just, if it wasn't for that, I was gonna play c3, etc. Play a dragon. Dragon. All the dreams gone. This is some tactic. Dreams destroyed. All the plans gone. Wiped out. After rook takes g4. Isn't that brutal? This is sort of looking some sort of dragon theory, maybe. So, I can't really see how this is gonna pan out at the moment. There's only 4 minutes of the tournament left, by the way. I think we've won this tournament. So well done, everyone. I think we've won the tournament. There's 55 points. The second one's actually withdrawn and he's on 38. Then the third one is on 30. Is that the person we just lost to? V Turoz is on 30. So given that there's only like 3:40 left, I think this tournament has been won, believe it or not. I know it's incredible. It's incredible news, but it looks as though the tournament's been won. I've just made this a lost position, by the way, with the d6 weakness, but nope, it's got really no compensation. But anyway, there's queen c8. That's about it, probably. A single move threat. And then. Doesn't even take it. Oh, I could probably like just annihilate the king here. Yeah, he's going for that instead. Rook g1, bishop h6, okay, f6. See, keep out the queen. Okay, so it's not so daft. Queen takes d6, rook takes c2, rook g1, rook f7. Was his move a little bit unsound there? Actually, I think the knight can just come in. Maybe that's the more serious issue here. Rook g1, rook f7, knight g3 looks like winning. Yeah, I think knight g3 looks winning. Something wrong with this position. Although the queen could actually help with queen c7 and still I c2, so knight g3. There's also king h7, takes check, queen comes in, probably killing. So maybe I'm gonna try this. I don't know. I'll try this. I mean, it's all murderous, this position. Now I think I'm gonna resign. It looks like murder to me, but anyway, somehow managed to win the tournament, so who cares? Okay, I mean, yeah, daily classical, yeah, good games all, yeah. Comments or questions on YouTube, yeah.